cities. What is your city like? How are you going to reach your city? Well, I think the best way is through praying for your city. So today we're going to look at how to pray for your city. Of course, we need outreach, we need mercy ministries and all these things, but prayer for your city is so important. And I'm going to begin with this quote by John Dawson. Your city is God's city. The people are made in His image. Satan is an invader and a usurper operating in our territory. God did not give demons authority over your city. Demons have infested the earth's atmosphere since before the creation of mankind, but they can only extend their authority into a town or an institution when people sin. When you look into the history of your city, you will find clues as to what is oppressing the people today. This is our planet, and the only authority Satan has is stolen human authority. Great quote by John Dawson. And in this quote, John Dawson emphasizes the fact that this is our planet and that your city belongs to God. So we're going to look at ways that we can pray for our city and we can bring authoritative intercession into our city and into houses of prayer if you have a house of prayer or your prayer meetings. Let's look at how to pray for your city. Well, first of all, cover your city with continuous praise and worship. This is so key in bringing in the atmosphere of God. God gives you His heart for your city through worship. As you worship, He gives you His mind. And then a positive attitude is important. Instead of complaining and reacting because of the sin in your city, praise God for the good things. Satan is already an accuser of the brethren. So praising God and declaring by faith the eternal purpose and dream of God for your city and over your city brings in His presence and defeats the enemy. And when I go to the nations, I pray over the city and praise God and worship God over the cities I go to because I know that brings in the very presence and the power of God. So cover your city with continuous praise and worship. And then wait on the Lord for insight. We can't depend on our own wisdom, but we have to listen to God with almost like a childlike dependence. God then opens our eyes as to what He wants to do in our cities, in your city, when you set aside your own agenda and wait upon Him. The Lord will give you His strategies for reaching your city. So waiting on the Lord for insight is very important if you want to reach your city in prayer. And then identify with the sins of the city. We can all identify with the roots of any sin in our city. The potential is in each one of us to sin, isn't it? And we need to identify in personal and corporate repentance. And there's been a lot of this going on for our cities, but it's still important. Nehemiah identified with the sins in his city, and he prayed this: I confess the sins we Israelites, including myself and my father's family, have committed against you. So there's sins against God. And that's in Nehemiah chapter 1, 6 and 7. So identify with the sins of the city and repent for those sins. And then overcome evil with good. Come in the opposite spirit. If there's a lot of violence, we can't be violent. We need to demonstrate the spirit of peace. If our city is full of greed, we need to demonstrate generosity. If there is hate, we need to live a life of love. When you do this, this will give you great victory in your city. And then travail over your city. Just like a pregnant woman travails to give birth to a child, you birth God's dream in your city through travail. And if you want a verse for that, it's John 16:21. You must pray until something happens. It takes dedication. It takes perseverance. But this has everything to do with faith for our city and revival. And the Apostle Paul is a good example. If you want to look up verses on this, 2 Corinthians 11, 27, 28. Those are some ways to pray for your city. And let me end with this quote by John Dawson. The level of the spiritual victory for your city is directly affected by two spiritual conditions: the intensity of your desire and the size of your faith. God wants to see if you want the minimum or the maximum. Do you want institutional survival or citywide revival. And we all want citywide revival, don't we? So Lord, we pray for our city. Help us to cover our cities with continuous praise and worship. Help us to wait upon you for insight. And Lord, we ask you to help us to identify with the sins of the city. When you show us where our city has sinned, help us to identify with those sins. And Lord, teach us and help us to overcome evil with good, to come in the very opposite spirit that we see in our city. And Lord, we want to travail over our cities. So help us to be like a pregnant woman, travailing to give birth to your dreams, your vision for our city. Lord, we ask you to help us because we want to see the level of spiritual victory in our city rise up. And we want to see you move in a maximum way in our city. We want citywide revival. Help us, Lord, to pray for our cities. In Jesus' name, amen. And God bless you.